Good afternoon and welcome to Music Scrap, the Musical Scrapper, here on Ustream.tv, or you could be watching the recording on YouTube. If you're watching the recording on YouTube, please be aware that we are live on Ustream.tv/channel/Music Scrap without an A. And so I am chatting with my fibs, my friends in the box at times, and you know, so if it's boring to you, just fast forward. That's what the scratch bar is for down below. Or if I have to go search for something, you know, I don't edit my 3 hours of video or so before it goes up to YouTube. So, anyway, enjoy. No, they don't, Xandra. I don't even tell them. I don't curse him the watched once when he was over in Germany, but no, I haven't shown them my channel, and I haven't shared my Twitter with them. They don't know I have a YouTube channel, because I'm just mean that way. Yay, Brenda, yay, B3, good for you. Good for her, I should say. Okay, so what I'm going to do, when I saw, a week and a half ago, was it? 2 weeks ago, I saw Diane Reevely do her video on the Ranger YouTube channel on her Black Dylusions journal. And I was like, I want that. I don't necessarily want square, but I would do a double layout anyway, so it wouldn't be square necessarily anyway. But, yeah. So, anyway, I show my sister my journal pages and stuff like that. I text her, you know, pictures and stuff like that. But, anyway, she works. They're all too busy anyway, caring for Mom to watch me anyway. And my younger sister has two jobs. She has no time to watch me anyway, even if she wanted to, so. But, so I decided, since I'm on a spending freeze, I keep saying that, but I definitely am now. The date for the Maryland retreat is out, so I have to make sure I can put extra money aside every month, because this year I'm going to have to pay my airfare because I won't have enough air miles. It took me 7 years to get 1,900 air miles to fly last year, to use them up. So, yeah, I won't be have enough to fly anytime soon. So, yeah, I know, Eileen, stop it. Stop it. But anyway, plus I thought, while I'm waiting, and I have the Black Dylusions on my Christmas list, if this doesn't work as well, if it works as well, hey, then I don't have to bother. So, what I have is black chipboard for the cover. And no, I'm not doing a stitched journal because I'm too lazy. Let's just put it that way. I have black binding rings. I'm going to use my cinch and make my journal. So I'm just going to leave it 8.5 by 11. Okay? And I'll probably work my journal this way because I like landscape. I know Dee Dee always likes working in portrait. I like working in landscape, so I will likely work with my journal this way. Carol is funny! Ha ha! Oh, Eileen hasn't bought anything yet this week. Sheesh. Oh, yes, Sarah, there's a black square 8x8 Dylusions journal, and her paints look amazing on the black. So, I have the Recollections 110-pound black cardstock. Now, I don't think Staples, or I've never seen 110-pound cardstock anywhere else. Not here on Mars, anyway. So, I bought this at Michael's, and I've been saving it. Oh, I bought it, like, probably last year. And I've been keeping it, as you can see, it wasn't open. I've been keeping it for a very special project. So I am opening it today for this special project. So it's a really nice way. Excuse me. You get 100 sheets, and I believe here, I think it was like, I want to say $19.99, but I used a coupon. So it's extremely thick. Oh, you know what? It's strange. It feels thicker. That feels thicker than Staples 110-pound cream and white cardstock. That's really weird. Why would it feel? It feels way heavier. Almost feels as heavy as some, like, cracker boxes. Wow. So, hey CB, can't remember if I said hi or not. So, anyway, here we go. So let's do the covers first. I'm glad I had, this is my last two 12x12 cards, black cardstock. I am so glad I had two left because then I don't have to cover it. I'm just going to leave it bare chipboard. That's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to make the covers just slightly bigger than the inside pages. I'm leaving the inside pages 8.5 by 11. So the 11 needs a quarter inch, well, not quite a quarter inch on either side. I'm going to leave about 3/8 of an inch total bigger. So let's do 11 and 3/8. Which means I'm taking off 5/8. 5/8 is right after a half. Sorry, all of you people who are mad because I'm doing math. Okay. Denise, but the 110-pound white cardstock at Staples isn't as heavy, and it's the same grams. It should be the same. I think, or I'm still misunderstanding, but okay, and now the 8.5 doesn't have to be quite 3/8. I'm just gonna do it because it's only the one side has to be larger. So 8.5, and then I'm just going to go, wait now, that would be 3/8, 8.5, so I'm just going to go a little wee bit, just enough to protect. I'm not going to go to 8 3/4, I'm just going to go to the 16th mark before the 3/4. Yeah, exactly, Sarah. Oh, okay, I see what you mean. Oh, I see what you mean. I gotcha. 297 GM. Ah. I bet it can't be then, Denise. I'll have to look later because I'm penned in. I see what you mean. I got you now. Gotcha. Hi, Kalina. You are probably right, Denise, obviously, because it's definitely way much heavier. Well, that makes good English, Jean. All right, I'm going to triple check because you know what they say. That will make some nice tags or something. So there's one cover. Mm-hmm. 5/8 off this way. anyone else I missed coming in? From Ella's show, she was making a really nice card there just before I came on. 8.5 and another 3/16 beyond that. Most definitely keeping the ends. Most definitely, Dee Dee. Yes, ma'am. So, now, next thing I need to do. Now, this one goes down in because I only use that Fiskars one now for chipboard. So, I have my Stampin' Up! One for paper. Okay. Woo! Hey, Lynn. Nice to see you. Okay, now I need to get out my, let's put my cinch down here and grab my rings. So I've got nice black rings. I was excited when I realized I still had some nice black rings. Okay. Okay, Ray. Oh, learned a lesson buying O-rings quite a while ago. I'm trying to remember where they had them on sale in bulk. Might have been Blue Moon or Simon Says Stitch. Somewhere I had them. And it was way back when I was just starting to buy things online. And they sold them in bulk. Well, or it didn't say in bulk. It actually didn't say that it was in bulk. What it said was 25 rings or whatever for a certain price. And it was a really good price. And they were antique brass, which is what I usually use, except in a special project like this. And so I bought them thinking they would be nicely like 4 boxes of this or whatever. No, they were all bulk. And they didn't have this piece of chipboard on the ends to keep them from getting all caught up in each other. So when I got them, they were all messed up, all caught up. And let me zoom out just a little bit on the camera because I'm going to keep going off screen if I don't. Oops, sorry. And zoom out. That should do the trick. Now let's autofocus again. Let's get some black in here. Woo! Sorry! Whacked into the camera there. Move my hand. And there we go. There we go. Now I don't have to worry about if I'm on screen or not, and there's not really anything detailed that you have to see up close with this part anyway. All right, so lesson learned. Hey, Paula! Nice to see you. Okay. All right, so. Oh, Ella, well, you were up earlier if you caught both of Dee Dee's shows this morning. Wow. Okay, so next thing I want to do is I want to see, I'm just going to stick those in there, so I better in my cart than on the floor. I want to see how many I can put in here and leave enough room. More than that, because I figure even if it doesn't work great for the paints, it'll work great for Prismacolor right? And I love my Delusions paint on it, so it's a journal I can use regardless. I'm just checking to see, because you want it to be less than half the size of your rings there, so that you get good turning. That should work. I don't care if they smooch out some and whatever. Take a couple off. Okay, so next up is Cinch. Now, I've talked about this before on streams, and I had my Bind It All first, and I loved my little Bind It All, but it now lives with Linda in Nova Scotia, Linda White Holloway, along with my Cricket, which also lives with her. So, I bought this. Now, this is not the first. This is the second one. So, they did make some improvements in this one. And it needs washed. It's like filthy. But there is, they have made improvements even from this one again. They also, this one makes round holes, which I do like better than the square ones. But they do make a Cinch now also that makes square holes or little rectangular holes, in case you like that better. What's a corrugator? Sarah, that's what takes the paper and gives it, or I shouldn't say, the milled paper stock, cardboard, whatever, and it turns it into corrugated cardboard. I have a hand one here where you can corrugate chipboard, or card, not cardboard, you can corrugate cardstock. Yours looks good still in the box. Eileen, did you get the blue one, Eileen? Okay, Kathy. Well, it takes cardboard and corrugates it to make it corrugate, right? Sort of. Anyway. So, on this, it tells you to look at the size that you're making, okay, and where to punch your holes. Now, my covers are a little bigger than 8.5, but I'm going to go by 8.5. So 11 inches. 11 inches. So 11 inches, I have to pull plug 10 on the second punch. So I punch first in home base, then I pull it all the way out, and on the second pass, I'm going to pull plug 10 so that the only one, wow, so it only punches up to number 10. Well, maybe I'm going to pull it. Ooh, sorry. Push it in. Excuse me. Push it in if you don't want it to punch. That means it's only going to punch as far as 9 holes the second round. Welcome back, Rain. Sherry. Hi, Sherry. Okay. So, I want to make sure they're all pulled out. All pushed in. What on earth is going on here? Why on earth would I have them all pulled out? No idea. That one doesn't want to go in. I've never had a problem with this machine. There we go. Hope it didn't seize up or something. There we go. Yeesh. All right. Yeah. Sorry. Pushed in. They all go down. You can tell because they all go down there, but that one's still acting up. There we go. Okay. Oh, you haven't rained. Oh, I am, Trina, but I'm not. Oh, I see what you mean. To put the rings on that side? Oh, I never even thought of that. I just thought I'd work with the rings at the top, but yeah. No, wait. That makes sense, Trina. Duh. Oh, you guys are just being silly. It's all working. It's fine. You're right, Trina. I was going to still bind on the long end and then work this way, right? And then, like, flip my thing this way, which is nice, too, because then that leaves the rings on the top and not on one side of my work. What do you guys think? What do you guys think I should do? Dee Dee, what do you think? What would you do? Like, I'm going to work on my journal this way. Should I bind it on that short edge and make it a long journal like this? Or should I bind it on the long edge and then, like, flip up instead of sideways? You think on the short side, Eileen? Denise thinks on top. Mindy thinks on the side. Okay, I'm going to probably end up with half the people saying side and half the people saying the top. So I have to think about this. Eileen says side. And I'm kind of thinking side now, too. Leanne thinks top. I like landscape. Exactly, Dee Dee. But what I'm asking is, should I put the rings on the side so that it flips landscape-wise, or should I put the rings on the top and have it flip up like a calendar? Hey, Janet. Yeah, that's true. However, the top won't get in the way of either side of my pictures, though. Right? Yeah. I wonder. Side. Sarah says side. Mo, Yeah, I do. I like landscape. But see, if I put the title on the book this way, then people will know to open it this way like a calendar. See, that's what I'm thinking, to open it like a calendar. CB. What's CB saying? Top. Got another top. Yeah, I'm thinking top. I'm still thinking top. I'm going to do the top. That was my first instinct, so that's what I'm going to do. Good thought, though, Trina. It was a good thought. Okay, so push it all the way in. Chipboard, I only do one at a time just because otherwise it's too hard. If I was standing up, I could do two chipboard at a time. So I'm going to do that. Oh, darn it. I was supposed to open it up a little bit. Dang it. Well, I'm going to put a decorative edge on it, I guess, because now I have to go with the other side. I have to move it. For the covers, I have to move it just a little bit because I'm doing them 3/8 bigger difference. So I have to do it kind of like in between. Just for the covers. That's all right. This will be the back. I'll just fill it in with that little strip I have. Okay. I'll keep it in that spot so that the other one is exactly the same. Covers are a little bigger, so I just switched that out myself. Well, if you made the covers exactly the same size as the inside, it would be no big deal. But I just made it harder on myself because that's kind of like what I do. I like to do things like that. So, then I line up the second one from the top, pull out the 10th pin, and notch. There we go. Oh, dang it. Didn't quite go in all the way. Just have to be more careful. Wow. Okay, something's stuck in my... One moment, please. I have to make sure you don't get paper stuck in here because then it doesn't go in, punch, go in all the way. There we go. I got a piece of paper stuck in there or something. I got it out of there. Well, good thing I have two thin strips to put back on my book because I'm going to punch again. This one's okay. Like it's in all the way. That's better. All right, let's do this one again the right way. Push that back in. See, it's easy. I apologize for making it look harder than it is. Hey, Sophia. FYI, this is only hard because I made my covers a little bit bigger than the inside pages, right? And I don't want them all to be down at the bottom. I want them to be centered inside, all right, the cover. That's the only reason this is hard, or making it look harder than it is. It is not the machine. It is me. It is my design, as usual. And if you do an interesting design, all you have to know is that this button here that goes down goes in the second hole that you already have punched from the top. And then it doesn't matter where the rest of the thing lies. Then it will all work out good. There, that's better. Now, the rest will be much easier because it just goes right on. So I'm going to punch them all first. Put those pieces on, those thin pieces. Alright, so I'm going to do them all first. Punches. Then I'll move the thing out, pull the peg, and do a second set of punches. Thank you. had a few too many in that one. It was a little harder. Sandy. You guys are so bad. I love math and geometry and fractions and... Well, let's just put it this way. I have made fewer mistakes with my cinch than I did with my bind at all. And the other nice thing about the cinch is you have to make fewer passes because it'll punch up to 12 holes at a time. The bind at all only punches 6. So I would have to do like 3 passes instead of 2, if not 4. It is rain. Oh no, this is way, 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 way easier. And actually, the nice thing about the cinch is that it's much more versatile than the I'll show you, just a moment. Just before I go on to the next set of punches, like for example, let's say I wanted to do, three holes at the bottom, then skip 3, then 3 holes, skip 3. Okay, so let's say I wanted to do that. That's the thing, you can do with this one, you can do fancy binding. The other one didn't go down. Oh yes, it did. Sorry. Okay, so you can do binding like that, and then I can cut my rings to put, you know, extra. So then I could turn it over and do there. So now I've got 3, 3, 3, and 3. So you can do like really cool. Wow, that's really dark now, isn't it? So you can do, see the cool binding? You could do 3 sets of 3 holes. Like, you can do lots of cool things. So, anyway, now I have to do my second set. So, just leaving the 11 open, pulling this all the way out. And just to make sure it stays steady, you put the little peg down in the hole there. There we go. And, oops, sorry. There we go. Perfect. Whoops. Come on. Stay, behave yourself now. Make sure it's in all the way to the top. Oh, wait, now I missed. What's awesome, Paula? Oh, cool, Paula. Carol, that's funny. Carol's hubby's getting a... Oh dear. Sorry, Carol with an E's husband's getting a cameo. Ah, that's so funny. Ah. Love it, Carol. Love it. Oops. Got to pick that up. There we go. Okay. Oops. Get it in the... What's going on? There we go. All right. And now, this is... Let's just say neither the Zutter nor this one is any good if you have a bad shoulder. But this one is much easier than the Zutter. Can I write with this one? That's funny. Janet, that's like us with Mom's scissors. Are we allowed to use these ones on paper, Mom? We used to say. Because as a seamstress, she had her... Yeah, sewing scissors. Of course, now that we're older, we know which ones we don't dare even breathe on. Even though she doesn't sew anymore, we're not allowed to use her scissors, her cloth ones. Well, unless we're cutting cloth, but none of us sew really that much, so. Oh, good, Rain. I'm glad your elbow is healing. Very nice. Don't know if I've missed anything else along the way, because I've been, as usual, so somewhat ignoring the chat. But, Paula, that's cool. Simon might do some coloring. Uh-oh, that one messed up. Dang it all. Hey. Just off slightly. There we go. We got some bigger holes. That's what I get. I was looking at the chat, and it moved. There we go. All right, perfect. Now, turn it around this way. All right, so I need, let's count the holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 holes. Yeah, Dee Dee. Okay, so 21. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should we leave 3 at the other end? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. And that leaves 3. Then I always put my scissors in there. And I always count a second time just to make sure. 2, 3, 1. All right. Oops. So put it to the edge. Oh, you guys can't see. Ha. Huh. Hold on one moment. Guess I don't really have to do it to the edge. So on the side here, the cinch has little prongs that you sit your rings on. All right. Now, you take your book. Put your cover on the front, put your cover on the back. Flip the front. Let's see. Hold on. Slip the back. Slip the back to the front. And then you put papers on first. because you want it between the back page and the back of the thing. I don't have too many pages to try and get on there at once. These are all the same, so it doesn't matter what order. You just have to remember that you put your back cover and front cover on at the end. Back cover. Okay. Okay, now the front and the back. Make sure I put the right ones in there. Yeah, that two messed up sides. All right. So, these are, I believe they're half, must be 1-inch rings. So I have to set it on 1 inch. Push it in, move it. Check them. They need to go a little bit more. I'd rather do it. Oh, these must be 1.25 inches because it's not going down enough. Earth. Actually, must be 5/8. That's better. That's it. Ta-da! So the back of your book. Remember, if you're watching the... Woo! Let's put this over here. Okay. Whoops. So the back of your book is going to be where your join is, okay? So this is now if the black paper in her Dylusional journal is as smooth as the paper in her other Dylusional journal, this isn't quite as smooth. It doesn't have texture, but it's not quite as smooth as the paper in her Dylusional journal. And I will do the cover in a moment, but I can't wait to see what it looks like on here. So, I'm going to, of course, start off on the first page with a cathedral stencil, I think. I mean, what else is good enough for this page? Oops. Oh. Hold on. I don't totally have these sorted. I haven't been putting them away properly like I should. Like a good little girl. So I'm not making sure I get the cardstock between them like I should. Okay. Alright, so let's put down. Now, if you've seen my previous stream, I do not like the pots that the Dylusional paints are in. So my Dylusional paints are now in these. Wonderful. Bottles, which I bought at Michael's. So there's my Dylusional. I did not get the white or the black or the brown because I have white and black and brown paint from elsewhere. So I think I'm going to use one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So if I cut each of these in half, then I'll have enough sponges. Hey, messy blogger. Hello, hello. Yeah, hate the tubs. Do not like them. So, and actually they were very easy. I thought I was going to need a funnel or something. I made a funnel out of acetate thinking I would need it for it to pour in. But it actually poured in very easily, very easily. And I have them dabbed on the top and labeled. So I'm going to start. All right, so I'm going to use most of these colors, actually. So at the bottom, I'm going to start with, all right, so let's cut these in half. Woo! Poof! These were, I don't know who took these to Maryland. Probably Vicky, I don't know. They were from something or the other. And people took some, and there were a whole bunch left on the table when we were getting ready to clean up the table. And I was like, hello, I'll take those. I use sponges all the time. They're cool. All right. All righty, there we go. It wasn't hard at all, Trina, to get them in. It was very, very easy. Yeah, exactly, Paula. Just had to figure out, like, it flowed very... The only one that was trouble at all was my pink because it was a little goopy. So I had to use my palette knife to do the pink one. But, you know, whatever. All right, I need a plate to use as a... Oh, no! Oh, no, oh, no! Stuff is falling everywhere! Whoops! Oh, KFC! Look at that! Okay, let's see where I am here. So I can move this over a little bit and still have room for my plate. Well, they look like hair rollers, but no, they were in something that she buys all the time. I don't know if it was her needles for her insulin or her box of insulin pens, or I'm not sure what it was, but it was in something. Yeah, I saw that, Sherry. Very cool. Sherry got her replacement. And I got my replacement purple, too. But I'm going to use this. But they must not be replacing purple. They didn't send... Or pink. They didn't send me the pink. I told them the pink that is So, all right. So I'm going to start with yellow. So we'll see if this works, stands out as nice as it does on her journal pages. Let's see. Because her on her journal pages, the paint stood was wonderful on the black. It was amazing. Looks good. Let's do that way. Next, I'll do light green. Oh, did Marianne go up? Bye, Marianne. Ella, this is a set of four stencils by our artist seller, Lisa at Artist Seller. And I actually won a drawing on Paula's show where I could choose a set of stencils from Artist Seller. And I thought I won 6x6s, but she said I could choose whichever I wanted, 6x6 or 12x12. Whichever one I wanted, I was like, hello, I'll take cathedral stencils, please, in 12x12. Yes, please. Like, hello. Course. Oh, this is gonna look pretty. CELLAR. Did it move? Oh, dang it. Of course it moved. There's no way to tape it, though. Because it's bigger than the... That's okay. I don't mind. Thanks, Paula. Yeah, that was a good night to win. Oh, gosh. Okay, so that's all I need of that color. So now I'll go to teal. Need a little bit more of this color though, because I've got more space to cover. I'll just have to be a little more careful to not let it move. I have been known to spray the back of my stencils with repositionable adhesive, but then you also have to be careful because sometimes it'll leave residue. Dang it! My stuck to my thumb! At least with this one, it's easy enough to replace it in the right spot. I've gotten over my it has to be perfect issues. Well, for the most part. They come out a lot more when I'm scrapbooking and doing pictures and stuff like that. Doing my movies, when I do movies, it has to be perfect in those cases, but Thank goodness, Eileen goes, that I've given up my perfectionism. Wow. Yeah, I know, eh? What can you do? This would have been easier, I guess, with a paintbrush because the spaces are so big, but oh well. Let's just keep going. Now, let's go back, and I want to put a little bit of yellow in these places here. So I just went to a paintbrush, and yes, I'm spreading the teal in with the yellow, but oh well. I just want a color variation in these little spots here, because in a window it would be... Yeah, finally becoming a whatever person for some things. Believe me, I've taken my crocheting out a number of times. That's another thing. It has to be kind of perfect. Perfect enough that the blocking will help it. Let's put it that way. Okay. All right. Now, moved again a little bit. That's all right. So now, now I need another contrasting. Of course, the magic will be revealed when I take the stencil off and the black comes through in these spaces. Carol! Ah, Rain! The dark side has cookies. Ah! Oh, dear. Anyway, sorry. Let's go to orange. So we're going from like the yellow, so warm, cool. We'll go back to some warm. Keep the eye moving. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. See, that's part of the yellow one. Or orange, not yellow. Okay, Jean. Uh-oh. This is going to be a tough one right there. Get that round section. Squish my sponge. Keeping you all in suspense while I do this the slow way. Not really any other way to do it with paint. Thank you. Orange seems to be a little more translucent even than the yellow, which is surprising to me. In other words, it's showing, the black is showing through more on the orange than the yellow, and I'm not really using any, like, less paint or anything. A little more yellow, orange, I mean. Okay, so. They're riveted. I'm keeping them in suspense. They can't wait to see what it looks like when I take off the stencil and reveal the black. That's the magic of these stencils, because really, they are incredible designs. And there's four stained glass windows in the design. They come in 6x6 and 12x12. Artist Celler, C-E-L-L-A-R. All right, so a warm, I need another warm, so I'll go to red. And I don't think I'm going to do anything on this outside. I think I'm going to stop here. I'm going to do yellow in here, but this is going to be my last row of color, I believe. I think that's what I'm going to do. Oh, is this red not yummy? Oh my goodness. Nope, no sneaky peeks. Oh, okay, Sandra, I'm going. Sandra has to go make supper. She wants me to finish. Okay, I'm hurrying. No sneaky peekies. Almost done, Z. Almost done. Oh, it moved on me again, but... All right, now just a smidgen of yellow again along the top. Dry it off because I don't want it wet. This is just cardstock. It's no fancy cardstock, so I don't want it any more wet than it has to be. Oh, where does the stupid page start? Oh, there. Okay. Oh, dang it. Gonna make that kind of like an orange because some of it spread down, so I may as well make it look like it was on purpose, right? All right, is everybody ready? Are you ready? I'm not sure, Paula. I haven't looked recently because I knew I didn't even open this yet. Oh, it really moved on me. Oh, look, I didn't even have it straight at all. Dang it. Oh well, whatever, it's a crooked window. Look at that! I didn't have it straight at all. But hey, isn't that nice, Paula? Hey, Paula, you know what I should do? I should do your black gesso technique without the black gesso. Try it right from the black cardstock and see what happens, especially now since I have my dilution sprays, right? All right, see you later, Zandra. Oh, 3 weeks vacation, Paula? Very good. Very good. That is great. Simon's on vacation for 3 weeks. Woohoo. You were, Paula? Cool. So, now, something went really weird. I am the worst stenciler in the world, folks. So, you know, the worst stenciler in the world. Okay. That's very nice. I like that. I'm just playing, so I'm not necessarily going to do pages. I'm just going to leave that like that right now. Let's do... I'm going to leave that page for now. All right, so let's just get my dilution sprays. Well, I got some of them. They were on sale at Joann's when I was putting stuff in my cart at Joann's, Sherry. So, yeah, I like the paints, so they sold me. It's the paints that sold me on the sprays. All right, so, well, I didn't get all the colors. I'm missing one... I'm missing one set of her brights, because, and that, and that. I used them last Monday, Sherry. I guess, oh, you weren't feeling well last week, were you? That's why you missed them? So I'm missing the orange and the red, I guess. Teal blue, purple, yellow, green, green. I'm missing the pink too. How come I'm pink, red, and orange? I don't know how that works, but anyway. Okay, Lynn, see you later. I know, right, CB? Who'd have thunk? Well, heck, who thought I'd ever be touching paint? Let alone sprays. Yeah, I bought all those Lindy sprays, and then I realized how messy they were, and I was like, I don't want to use these. They're messy. Sorry, I've got to get my little scissors out here. Because. Oh, nice, Leanne. Nice sun to make ribs for you. I'm hungry. I haven't had anything since my shredded wheat at 10:30 or 10 o'clock when I get up. All right, that was tough. All right, what else one's still in its package? The dark green's still in its package. All right, so Paula, I have to start with one with smaller, right, with a small pattern, and then go to a big pattern. Okay, big pattern with the white gesso. Okay. And the teal. No, teal's out of its package. Mostly. I think, yeah. Okay, so it was just the two of them that weren't in their package anymore. Alrighty. Alright. No, CB. I only splatter and splatter in controlled situations. Controlled situations. Yes, Rebob. Okay, so, small openings stencil. Oh, one moment, please. Let me get my box of stencils up here. It's heavy. So, I think, let me see here. All right, so I need one with larger openings and one with smaller openings. And smaller one has to go first. Oh, may I do my chevrons for the first one? Chevrons is an idea. Oh, this would be cool. My first one. Okay, now I need a big one for bigger holes for my second stencil. Let's see. I could use the cathedral again, but I really should vary my... Let's see what patty one I have here. That one has some nice big openings. And that would fit perfectly like this, wouldn't it? That's one option. Okay, I think, there's this one. Maybe I like that one better. I don't know. That one. All right, I'm just going to take out three because why take out more when you've got three good to choose from? Okay, so I'm going to do this one for my spray round. And I'll spray it twice there. Oh, does it, Sherry? You tried the Black Recollections? Ooh, cool. And then either this one. Oh yeah, I think I'm gonna go for that now that I put that down there. Alright. So I'm just gonna stick those in the front. I know I have to go back and put them in the right spot later. Okay, so sprays. So what colors? I think I'll go with teal and green and yellow, I think. Okay. So this is a Paula's technique based on, I believe, something she saw. I think Julie Faye Van Balzer do. And then I'm going to move it down here. And just do a couple of spritzes. Let's do a yellow. And then let's move it over here. And do a... And green. And teal. And up here. Whoops. That didn't go very far, did it? And yellow. And it's probably messed up because it was sitting up there. Yeah, not bad. All right, so now I need something to clean this off on. So I'm just going to grab a piece of cardstock here. I don't have my Dylusional journal close enough, so I'm just going to lay that down. Can be base for a... Let's do a sandwich, as Patty says. Oh, is Patty streaming tonight? Oh, Thursday at 6:30. Oh, okay. She didn't say whether she was streaming tonight, though, did she? Because sometimes she streams on Monday after me. I just kind of got a little bit of a mess, but that's a start for some jelly plating. Look at that. Look at that. That's pretty. Look at that. Cleaned off my stencil. Cleaned off my stencil. Now I need to dry this. Yes, Patty is revealing her new line of stencils. Thursday, Inky Obsessions. At 6:30, she has stencils through iStencils.com. And they're going to have a sale, promotion. It's always 15 or 20% off usually. Sometimes free shipping. She showed us the cool free stencil you're going to get for usually $25. And at least one of her stencils, usually. Okay. Oh. I'm just glad I don't have a carpet when I spilled all my coffee this morning. Thank goodness. All right, so that's dry. So now I take the other stencil with the larger openings. And I'm going to put on some gesso, white gesso. Hello, where are you? Oh, there it is. Never mind. Found it. Think I'll use my other one for the white gesso, just so it doesn't get all messed up with the... Melt the wax and pick it up. Remember when Dee Dee made me almost wreck my nice cuckoo clock die? Putting it in the UT? Heat gun saved the day there too! Oops. Oh, shoot. A little too much gesso there, Jean. Look at that. Cool. You guys can see it coming through. Look. See the dilutions come through the stencil? Coming through the gesso, I should say, I mean. Well, I mean, hello. Dee Dee tells you to do something, you do it, because, like, Dee Dee knows everything, right? I mean, come on. Yep, it is. So this is one of those times, you know, we're always talking about everyone inks that stay permanent underneath and da-da-da. And yes, in some cases you don't want something in your bottom layers that's going to do this. However, we are now, I just went under that, so that's going to take away that nice shape there. We are taking advantage of the fact that these reconstitute themselves when they get wet. So we're taking advantage of that fact on our page. I need a good quote about making waves for this page. Someone know a good quote about making waves instead of not making waves? Oh, yeah, it would be. You're right, Ella. Of course. I usually have it on my right. Don't ask me why I was putting it on my left. Don't ask me. That's strange, because I do usually have it on my... This one is tough for sponges, because it's so... There's so much open space that you have to be careful, because the lines move on you. Ah! See? Like that. And your sponge can get caught in a corner. Usually have my palette on my right and stuff, but that was so, I don't know why I do that on my left today. That's weird. But thank you, Ella. Does make life a lot easier. Oh dear. I'm finding with this black sponge that, unlike with a cosmetic sponge, you have to keep snipping it off because it transfers. I'm not finding with this sponge that I'm getting that transfer like you get with a makeup sponge for some reason. Whatever the reason, I don't know. Okay, you ready for the reveal? Once again, there's a little magic that happens here because the black is, there are going to be black lines too. Ready? Woohoo! There we go. Like Joycey says, Maybe I'll just put, sometimes it's fun to make waves. Look at that. Look. It's cool. It worked, Paula. Oh, that's a good one, Eileen. Don't worry if you are making waves simply by being yourself. The moon does it all the time. That's a good one. It's fun, Sarah. So your first, if you don't have black cardstock, you put a layer of black gesso or black acrylic paint on your paper. Then it has to be water-soluble sprays. So the dilution sprays or the Tim Holtz stains. When I tried it with his re-inkers, I didn't have much success. But the sprays or the stains work great. Your first stencil has small holes, small design. Let it dry. Then with a stencil with the larger openings, you do your white gesso. Hey, Leanne. So I need to dry this before I can do my quote. I'm just going to print it on in black. That's true, Paula. You're right. And I'll say that on camera just so that the people know. I couldn't find my black gesso. Well, it's in here somewhere. Who knows where? Probably went underneath my desk into the abyss. Oh, I was supposed to show my journal today, too. I was supposed to do a journal flip, and I can't find my playlist journal I have to find. So I apologize to the person who I promised I would do a journal flip today. I will have to do it on my next stream, and I will find, I think it's down, way down behind my desk. So Paula says, if you use black gesso, even over black cardstock, okay, the colors will be more vibrant because on cardstock, more of that color soaks into the card itself, into the cardstock. And so, yeah, with black gesso and Dylusional paints, it'll come through even more vibrantly. So, yeah. I know, Sarah, that's why I put off getting them forever. But you know what? My craft scrubby got it all totally off. Now, who knows? Luckily, my computer's over there, so it didn't get any of the spray. But I tried to keep it low enough to... Nope, still a little wet up there on the top. I must have used more paint because I did up there first. Must have used a little more gesso up there. Okay, so my good old Bic, whatever it's called there. Where's my black one? Uh-oh. Oh, I had it the other... Oh, there it is. Phew! I was going to say I had it last night. Oh, bye, Leanne. Thanks for coming. Enjoy your ribs. Okay, so I'm going to scroll back to Eileen's quote here. I saw this, that it was on a few places. So don't worry if you're making waves simply by being yourself. The moon does it all the time. Okay. Don't worry if you are making waves simply by being yourself. The moon does it all the time. So I think I'll start on the second one. So don't worry if You are making waves. Oh, I just saw Ash come in. Hello, Ash. Hope your dad's okay. You. Are. Making. Waves. Simply. By. Being. Yourself S-E-L-F. The moon O-N does. It all the time. Now I think I'm going to go over that with my memento. Is there anyone attributed to that quote, Eileen, or is it anonymous? Hey, Ange! Or maybe my, where is it? Where'd you go, my memento pen? There it is. Oh, no, that those are both VersaMark. Okay, other big black one is my memento. There it is. Anonymous? Okay. Woohoo, yay, Ange! Yep, B3. Quick. Very simple pages. Little paint and a quote. Thank you. Period. The moon. Use the other tip. It's just a little blacker than. Should have used the fine tip though, I guess, anyway. Hey, Sophia. Okay, good night. Thank you for coming, Sophia. Excuse me. Oh, yeah, that end is not going to work as well on the acrylic, on the gesso. Better use the brush tip. And I'll put the date with my white pen. So it's October. What's the date today? The 5th? I think, right? Yeah. Next Monday is the 12th. So remember, please, I will not be streaming next Monday or on Saturday because I will be at my mom's. So it is October 10th. 10/05/2015. Alright, so, I need to put something on the, I need to put my little strippies on the front here, strips of black, since I messed up. There are they, there they are. That's the perfect size, too. So let's see. I still have a little time left, I think. Getting hungry, but it's okay. I can wait. It's not like I'm going to wither away. I've got lots of... All right. I should paint them before... Hello. Put my journal under here. Yes, I think I will paint them before. Which green? Do I want the light green or do I want the dark green? Thank you. I'm going to go for dark. I haven't tried the dark yet. Hey, Patty! Look, Patty. I've made today. I made a black journal. And you trying out my Dylusional paints on the black. The very wonky stenciling job, but anyway. And then I did Paula's gesso technique. You'll probably recognize that top stencil with my Dylusional sprays. So are you going to stream or are you too busy tonight, Patty? I know you streamed on the weekend, but you know, we can never have too much Patty in our life. This chipboard would also work much better if you had gesso on it. I may have to do a second coat on this. Which is fine. That's easy enough to do. Oh, okay. Yeah, you're going to have a busy weekend next weekend. Yeah. Bankrupting us all yet again. Sheesh, Patty. Yeah, I can just feel it soaking right into the chipboard because, of course, it's just raw chipboard, but that's okay. All good. It's all good. I'll do another coat. I think I'll leave the edges black. Exactly, Patty. For sure. Definitely, I already promoted your stencil release. So, did that a little earlier. Well, I guess I have to do the sides of this one because it's half done. Yeah, I know. The deals always seem to come halfway in between my pays too, Pam. Okay. All right, let's go for a second coat. Oh, I have to do a first coat on this one first. On the edges. These are little pieces that I have to put over the accidental hole punches that I made in my journal. Trying to punch it when I made slight errors. Yeah. Oh well. I'll have enough to buy maybe two stencils this time, so I hope I have enough saved. The edges, and let's do another coat on the top. Let's hope this one stays nice and bright. So, I don't know if I'm going to use only delusions, but I was thinking of titling this journal Going Dylusional. What do you think, you guys? So, oops, a little more than I thought there. Alright, I'm officially starving now. Okay, so now, you know, I have a little bit of yellow here, so I think I'm just going to brush on some yellow, use up that paint. Ah, there we go. Well, that's nice. Woohoo! Whoops! Yellow, Jean, yellow. There we go. Sweep it on. Trina. Okay. That is cool that you guys are almost neighbors. Wow. on. One moment, I've got kind of a blob of paint here, and it may not dry. Oh, it's almost dry anyway, even in the blob. Just can't be wet at all, or it won't be held down by the tape. Excuse me. All right. Let's glue this or tape these babies on here. How perfect was it that I just happened to have okay, I'm very unhappy with the Huggies baby wipes I bought. I bought the ones that come in the individual packages, but I didn't realize that they don't pop up. They're like folded in half. Oh, that's annoying. And I have a whole bunch of them to go through. Dang it. Anyway. And then they're stuck together so you can't get them unfolded. Oh, forget it. Okay, bye, Patty. No, they don't. No, they won't, Ella. They're folded on top of each other. They're not interlocked. They're not the baby wipes ones. They're the Huggies toddler ones. They're not the baby ones. They're the toddler ones, and they do not interlock. Nope, they do not. They're folded in half. They're not interlocked. So, unfortunately, that's why I'm ticked off. Didn't know that when I bought them. So I will not buy them again. So I'm just using double-sided tape here. Oh, well. Not like you still can't use them, it's just annoying, that's all. Just annoying. I'm gonna put a teeny tiny piece on top of here when I start peeling this one off, because I didn't quite get to the end with this one at all. Now to get it peeled off. Put this on the end. If it sticks at all now, since it was stuck on my finger. Okay, so, oops. Yeah, that's what I'm going to be doing at my mom's, Ange, next week, because my crocheting is all for family who are going to be at the house, so I can't really take my crocheting home with me. Plus, it's too bulky anyway. It's a pain in the patootie. So, I am taking home my coloring books. That looks pretty. Look, a nice little accent. There we go. Hey, maybe Paula wants to come on after me. Since Patty's not streaming. Bye, Ella. Thank you. Enjoy your day, because I know it's still somewhat early out there for you. Oh, I don't whistle either. Ange, that's the extent of my whistling. My singing teacher at university used to laugh at me. Till can whistle better than me, and he's like 4 years old, for goodness sakes. Yeah, my singing prof at university used to laugh at me because he said, you're the only, in his years and years and years and years of teaching, he said I was the only teacher, student he ever had that couldn't whistle. Oh my goodness. Anyway. Yeah, Ange, you do sing. I'll get you singing next year in Maryland, since I didn't know this year that you sang. But I had you singing with me. Oh! We should have a karaoke night next year in Maryland. We can take turns doing karaoke while everybody's arting in the evening. That would be so fun. Okay, now. There. All right, so that's the front of the journal. Yeah, no, Carol would never get a New York cab. Not me. I'd have to take Patty with me. Patty can whistle up a storm, let me tell you. She can hail a cab. She can hail a cab and good. Oh, wait now. That's my watercolor one. I don't want to... That's my watercolor. There. Okay, so... All right, so I want to do it in white and then paint it in. And what do you think? Going dilutional? Even if I use more than dilutions in it? Yeah, could have been a set of drums, yeah. No, well, you know what? If it's with people I know and friends, it's like kind of okay. But there's nothing worse than going to a bar where they have karaoke with all these drunk people who couldn't carry a tune if they were sober singing. It's like, that's no fun for me. But if it's like a group of friends, it's not so bad. But okay, so I think I'm just going to go for it. That's what came to my mind, going dilutional. And so I think that's what I'm going to call it. So. Maybe I'll just leave it in white and not use the... Well, of course, it makes more sense to use the paint, but... Well, that didn't meet up. Whoops. introvert, man. No. Oh, hello. White pen. There we go. I don't know why it's not working. It's working. That doesn't even look like a G. Oh well. Yay, Pam! It's raining! She's obviously on the West Coast because no one on the East Coast would be saying that. Did she get stuck there, Pam? Okay, so you. Eesh, Pam. 49. That's what it was. 63 here today is the high, but it was like 35 overnight, so it's like, yeah. Oh, that's perfect right there. Right? These spots. All right, Pam. Yes, yes, I knew you were there. I knew that. I knew that! All right, so let's bring my colors back. A little more light green. A little more yellow. And a little more teal. A little red. A little orange. I guess I'm going to have to get the other three colors in here too somewhere. Oops, I didn't need that much yellow, orange, blue and purple and pink. Oh, don't need that much blue either. I guess I'm going to have to do something on another page because... and I have lots left over paint. I can always do stripes on a page. Okay. I need another one for here. Oh, I didn't put any more dark green down, I guess. Oh, missed that one. Oh, I best not put dark green next. Where's my yellow spongy thingy? Where'd it go? My yellow spongy's gone. Where it went. I'm gonna have to grab another sponge because I need one for... All right, so I've got one for blue, got one for purple, and I need one for pink. So one more sponge, cut it in half, and all's good. Ouch. All right, so now I'll go to light green to work my way through the... I'm gonna have to do a second coat, I think. Now work to this. And red. And orange. Oh, no, orange. Purple. Oh, and that went. Got a little brown going there. And blue. And it's purple. Pink. Whoops. All right, so let's go over it and do a second coat. Okay. All right, orange. Yellow. I didn't put any dark green in there, so I'm going to have to stick some in here with the green, between the green and the yellow, get some dark green in there. And then the light green. And then the teal. Then the red, which has gone a little bit purpley there, but that's okay. And purple. And blue. I should have stayed on rainbow order and all would have been better. And pink. All right, let's go. Ta-da! I like that. That is cool. I like that. Look at that. Black journal for myself. Now I have to decide what I'm gonna do with my, if I'm gonna, I might just leave those, I might just kind of like that, and I might just leave my letters, just do some lines or something and leave them white. But I think I want to, one moment please. Don't want to waste this, you know? Get some splotches on the back. Let's get some let's get a baby wipe. Oh, right. I can't get them out that way. Dumb non-interweaved baby wipes. Do not buy the toddler baby wipes. Because they're a pain in the butt. I think I'll do it on the back. Find a cleanish spot. Wasn't enough for the other to show up, but oh well. Oh well. It's clean. Is that dilutional enough for you, Eileen? Ha ha ha. Is it? Is it dilutional enough for you? But there's the cover. I like that. Love the cover. But I think I need something in each corner here. Thank you. that had some blue on it. Why do I have that on my right again? Left again, I mean. Jeez Louise. Okay, so. There we go. Let's dry that. I'm gonna have to use up that paint. No, I'm not doing splats. Forget it, Eileen. Forget it. Pitch. Hey, Linda. It's 110-pound cardstock. Look, Linda. So I used the paints with the crooked stencil went crooked on me. Dang it. But anyway, whatever. Because I just decided I wasn't going to pay for one of their journals. I left the back blank. Just I'll go back and do it. Then I did a Paula without black gesso, just with the cardstock. Of course, with gesso, it would have come through even more, but you can see how it came through very nicely there. Yep. And so now I'm decorating the covers. Carol. Yes, I have been taking a break from my crocheting, resting my poor arm. Oh, this muscle right here gets so sore from crocheting, and this finger right here is developing a very nice blistery pat. Trying to decide whether it's going to be a callus or a blister. Thank you. So when is your mom's closing date, Linda? And please let me know the detail of yours and Dan's show, because if I can get down at all to where you have your show, I will be there. That's all little circles, by the way. All right, so, I can do squares or colored stripes. So do stripes, but color them in, I guess. Oh, cool. Not a long time, but not too long either, so that's good, I guess. I think I need, just to bring the white down, I think I need a white line along here. I'm going too fast. And then along here. Sorry, I had to do that while I was well, I was thinking about the next letter because it just kind of hit me. I needed those lines, those white lines. All right, next one. All right, I'm gonna do little squares, checkerboard, I think. Oh, okay. Well, that will definitely help, Linda. Definitely help that she's already partially packed. Yeah, I had mine about when I sold my house. We had like 3/4 of my stuff packed up for showing. Luckily, I had a shed and we moved it all into the shed. Hey, bunny. Oh. Oh, okay, well, no problem. Glad you can pop in at all. With all your fall cleaning. Well, that worked out weird. Strange. That didn't work out right, but anyway, whatever. Kind of worked. The end. Oh, yeah, that's a good idea, Kia. Or Jillian, I mean, yeah. This is on the back, but gone. Good idea. I like that. I'll be the gone delusional. But yes, I just FYI, I love my dilutional paints much more, even more in this, in these bottles. Let me tell you. I mean, I know she likes the jars because she likes to, go right in with her brayer and yada, yada, yada. But no, too much chance for me to spill and eesh. All right. I have no ideas for the why. I think I'll do squigglies this way. No, I already... Okay, it has to be one that's kind of more open because this one's pretty dark. Alright, so let's do them this way this time. Lines going this way. The end! I know, Carol, it's hilarious. How on earth? I just opened them and just poured. The only one that was tricky, at first I thought I was going to have to, make a little funnel. Actually, for the first one, I did make a funnel from acetate. But they actually poured extremely well, except for the purple. The purple was goopy, so I had to use a, one of my triangle scrapey thingies to get the purple in. But the rest, I just had it open, and I just tilted it on a 45-degree angle, whatever, and it just poured right in. And then the end of it, I got in with the craft scraper thingy. Hey, Laurel. Nice to see you. You never get to my streams. I made this journal today. Black journal, so I can use my dilution paints, well, and my PBOs, because we all know how much I love my PBOs, so I will be using this for my PBOs as well, of course, and who knows, illustrating with white, white pen illustrations, whatever, I just thought I'd have a black journal. Zigzag. Chevron. Don't have a chevron one yet. And let's do just sideways squiggles like this. I did. Thank you, Rain. You never know, Gina. Never know. But I just bought these. They come 6 in a pack at Michael's for $5.95, I think. And then they weren't on sale, and I didn't have a coupon, but I get 15% off as teacher anyway. But so I bought 2 packs because they come 6 in a bottle. So I have a few left for... Actually, I have a couple of my large tubes where the cover won't close right. So I'm hoping to rescue some from that and put it in here. Put it in jars too, so... Well, I don't know if I see them mixed better. The only one I had trouble with was my purple, and it seemed to come out fine today. I put a little bit of water in with it when I put in the bottle, and my pink as well. I put a little bit of water in both of these when I put them in the bottle. But I know they certainly won't dry up as quickly. I know that for sure. So, yeah. I think I'll draw them first, and then I'll decide which ones get colored.
So that one's not colored. This one's going to get colored. This one's going to get colored. This one gets colored. And the one on the very end gets covered. All right, so this one I'm going to do lines straight across because I don't have one with lines straight across yet, and I'm going to make them kind of close. It's too many letters in this word to come up with. And I was not zentangling or anything, it's just doodling. Didn't like the smell? Oh, they do have a bit of a plasticky smell, but that's strange because I have a very sensitive nose, and they didn't bother me any more than the other good paints. I don't have many, but my PBOs kind of smell a little bit too. Maybe you won't notice the smell as much, Alinda, if you get them transferred into bottles. Our next crop is the 23rd and 24th of October. So is whether Christy's going to be up here again. With her store. So the only thing I have ordered from her this time is the new purple September paint. They do smell plasticky, but okay. Three letters left until how. She said as long as the weather's okay, I'm thinking it's only the end of October. Don't say things like that, Christy. Don't jinx us. All right, one more. All right, let's do zigzags again. I guess it's
good as anything else, isn't it?
There. Going Dylusional. What do you think, guys? I need one more line. Sorry, I have to have three. It's driving me crazy. There. I've got spots and dots. Thanks, bunny. So, yeah, I like it. Well, I am going to sign off because it's 8 o'clock and I have to have something to eat. Yes, I haven't eaten since 10:30 this morning when I had some shredded wheat. All right. Way to go. Dylusional paints. Dylusional sprays. Dylusional journal. Whoops, one more spray. I was going to say, I think there's a spray missing. No, it's not my stencil. This is one of the stencils I got from at Christie's for $5. It's got all these different borders on it. Isn't that cool? So, thank you everyone so much for coming. And I'm just going to go into my journal. Maybe on this back page. And I'm just going to use up my leftover paint. And it can be the beginning of a page or whatever. So I'm just going to simply... swipe leftover paint. No need of wasting it. So, like I said, I want to thank everyone for coming tonight, today. My yellow got all mixed up, but that's okay. Ooh, that's pretty, actually. Blend it there nicely. Ooh, that blends very nicely with this sponge. These sponges. Okay. I've got lots of orange, so I'm going to have quite a bit of orange to cover here. I'll come back and do a second coat because I've got lots to cover up here. Let's do my blue. I know, I shouldn't do the blue next to the orange, but what can you say? I'll just leave a little black. And the pink. Gonna make myself some little purple there. Thanks, Linda, for coming. Thanks, Carol. Yes, that was a white signal. White signal pen. Uniball. My favorite. White pen. Always works for me. I store them pen nib facing down. I don't think I have any red left, so... might be a little red left on that. Just a little bit. Just enough to give it a bottom there. All right, now I've got a little orange left, so I'm just going to go over that again. Okay. Alrighty. Now I'm gone for good, for real. Thank you so much.